Okay, so balik na naman tayo sa ating multi-time frame analysis na series, no? And I asked for some requests sa Investa, and IMI was one of the names that I got. So that's what we're gonna look at today. As always, let's go sa higher time frame muna. Let's start sa 3-month. Ay, masyadong ano pa? Okay lang ba? No, let's just start sa 1 month kasi konti pa lang yung candles overall. So, as before, let's mark out yung mga key points. Okay? First is yung open ng IMI from before. Diba? Na-mention ko naman ito. Let's mark it. Open price. So this was from when the stock first opened back in January 2010. Okay? Hindi ko alam kung yan yung IPO price. Ulitin ko lang. Wala rin akong balak hanapin. All I know is basta dyan tayo nag-open. Okay? And you can see from the monthly chart how that price was respected both ways. Diba? When it came down here, it acted as support. Support here. When it broke down, it acted as resistance. Came back, acted as resistance, came back, acted as resistance. When we eventually broke out, acted as support, broke down, acted as minor resistance before we broke up. And ngayon, it's once again acting kinda as both. No, kasi parang nakastraddle tayo ngayon this open price of 9.3 and nasa 8.8 tayo ngayon, no? And then, same as before, let's zoom in a little bit. Okay, let's identify yung mga key levels na makikita natin dito sa monthly. So for me, the first one is this. Let's just make sure na visible sa lahat. Okay. Tapos imamark ko din to. Even though this candle never closed above this high, never closed above yung 14, I just want to remember na tumama tayo more or less at 15 para lang naalala ko. Okay. From this time frame, ano ba ang nakikita natin? Diba? Price fell. Okay. So it was on an uptrend here, kinda. Okay. Here, not kinda, I mean, it pushed up, medyo parabolic yung move, broke down, diba? Ang sabi natin from the last time na nag-multi-time frame analysis tayo was usually mga ganitong moves yung mga sunod-sunod na malaking candles na akain in due time, which in this case, nakain nga, lumagpas pa, diba? Pati ito, parang kinain na rin, no? Itong mabilis na move na to, itong mabilis na move, kinain, okay? So, came down, took this, formed a lower high, then push even lower. So this low, we formed a new lower low. Diba? Definition ng downtrend. At least from this very, very high time frame, no? Well, not very, very high. From this high time frame, no? But now what we're trying to see, what we're looking at is price is trying to reestablish itself, trying to push back up dito sa time frame to see if we can form a new high to break this structure here. Diba? Kasi ito yung structural high natin. Pero in this time frame at least, di tayo nag-hold. It broke it, but it didn't hold. So ako personally, I'm not very eager kapag ganon. In fact, nakikita ko na kapag ganyan, tapos ganito nangyayari. Trap yan eh. Bull trap, na-trap yung mga bulls, binentahan, ganyan. So kaya mabilis, maraming nag-cut. Diba? Kasi malamang, dito sa baba nito, iniisip na iba, ah okay, kapag sa monthly ako nakatingin, may shooting star, kapag nag-break tayo below niyan, kakat na ako, or kung ano pa man ding reasonings ng mga tao, or at 12 pesos, psychological price. So, broke down, yeah, pulled back almost to yung low ng shooting star here, then it held, then pushed even lower, now we're consolidating here, at least based sa monthly time frame na tinitingnan natin, no? The next level is yung pinaka-low, kailangan lang natin i-note. Okay? And then the range that we broke out from. So, somewhere around here, more or less. It acted as support here, resistance here. So, from this time frame, it would seem like IMI is trying to make up its mind. Meaning, hindi pa siya sure kung ano ba talaga gusto niyang gawin. It could still collapse. But it could also form an inverted head and shoulders pattern here, then push higher. Okay? Inconclusive. Let's look at the weekly time frame now. So sa weekly time frame, mas obvious yung nag-downtrend tayo, di ba? Mas kita yung mga ebbs and flows, mga peaks and valleys, di ba? Peaks and troughs, or troughs, kung paano man i-pronounce yun. Okay? Tapos yun nga, ngayon, we're trying to push higher, pero ngayon, nag-pull back tayo, no? I would mark out this area as a potential support sa weekly. Okay? Then I would mark out this area. So potential resistance. So itong area na to kasi it encompasses even these lows. So again, always think in terms of area rather than just one specific price per line. Okay? Para sa akin, pag nakikita ko to, it encompasses this. So ito yung support, resistance. Diba? And ito naman, pwede nyo sabihin, kung nag-breakout tayo dito sa range na yun, that's true, no? Pero even if we broke out here around 11 pesos, would you be very bullish at least in this time frame? Hindi pa, diba? Kasi parang iisipin mo, mauntog pa ako dito dito sa area na to. So I would rather see price clear that para masabi ko na, something has happened. The turn has begun, no? But right now, as we can see, high, low, lower high, lower low, lower high. Titingnan natin yung kung mag-form siya ng lower low. Kung mag-form siya ng lower low, let's say we broke down sa 8.5, then what are we looking at? We're looking at itong range na to, yung 7.2 to 8.5, at least sa weekly, na pwedeng paglaruan ng price moving forward. Diba? Now, ranges, for me, okay, and this is just for me, you don't have to agree, I prefer na parang ganito, na mas may allowance, rather than trying to predict and make it super tight. Diba? Tapos, madi-disappoint ka lang, bakit ganun, bakit ganyan, mali ako. Okay, hindi po tayo exactly yung mali. Talagang ganun lang ang market, no? Ang market, wala namang kinikilingan yan, eh. Wala siyang pakialam sa mga guhit ko, wala siyang pakialam sa mga guhit nyo, wala siyang pakialam sa mga RSI, moving averages, MACD, or whatever else. Wala. It will do what it does, tas tayo nag-react lang. So usually, since ganun yung situation, I prefer more breathing room, kumbaga, when mapping out my charts. But regardless, even at this time frame, we can see na we're on a downtrend. Mid-term downtrend, no? Mid to short-term downtrend. Then finally, let's look at the daily chart. So yun nga, if we look at the daily chart, at this in this chart, pwede natin lagyan to. Mas minor siya na level. Okay? Mas minor siya na level here. We can even draw a line here kung saan nag-breakdown tong mini range na to. Okay? And we can even put a line there. Okay? Resistance, support, and so on. Bakit di ko siya ginawa sa weekly? Kasi di siya as significant sa weekly. Sa daily, mas kita mo yung mga tinatamaan niya. So, dito ko siya ilalagay. Okay? So, sa daily chart, what it's looking like to me is, syempre, downtrend pa rin. Alam naman natin, we had a higher time frame bias based sa monthly, based sa weekly. It's trending downwards. Okay? So, sa daily, it's also trending downwards, but it's looking like it's trying to form a range, which na-mention din natin kanina. So, I want to see what price does around this opening price and yung 8.5 na support na to. For all we know, it could come back here, hold, push back, form a range between 8.5 and 9.85 na pwede nating i-trade or pwede nating i-take advantage of if mag-present the opportunity. Okay? Or it could just break down here, then maybe we trade this range below. Again, yung from 7.2 to possibly 8.5. Okay? But I still marked out yung kunyari to 7.9 na level, 9.8. Just so in my mind, even though meron tayong higher time frame bias, para if the lower time frame bias starts working out, diba, meron na akong plano, meron na akong mapa kung ano titignan ko kung sakali man may magpresenta na trade sa kanya. Okay? Yung volume, mapapansin natin, moving downwards din tayo. In fact, you could probably draw a trend line na pababa sa kanyang ganito. Diba? Ignore yung mga nasa gitna. Basta yung overall direction niya is moving down. So, kung may hawak na tayo, depende kung saan tayo pumasok. Eh, no? Let's say, bumili ka ng mga close to 11. Siguro naman, by now, nakalabas ka na. Diba? Kung hindi pa, then you need to restructure your plan. Okay? You need to restructure your plan to understand what is it that you want to see. Kung magpatuloy yung downtrend, anong gagawin mo? Diba? Kasi yun yung nakikita natin sa higher time frames. Eh. Kaya tayo nagong multi-time frame analysis is para mas meron tayong idea moving forward kung who is in control. And usually, kung who is in control, mas visible, kumbaga, sa higher time frames. In short, yung lower time frames, sumusunod lang yan eh. diba? Yes, mas maaga mo makikita mga reversals sa lower time frames, but the overall flow is usually dictated by mga higher na time frames. So right now, the overall flow is bearish pa. Okay? So, kung may hawak again, nakabili sa taas, kung di pa nakakalabas, make sure you have a plan kung ano ba talaga hinahanap nyo. Kung magpatuloy yung bearishness, mag-break yung 8.5, anong gagawin nyo? Let's say naman, bumili kayo dito kasi feeling nyo, nag-bottom na. You need to have a plan then on what you want to see. Diba? Ano yung magiging bearish sa'yo? Pag nag-below ba ng 8.5? Pag nag-below ng 8 pesos? Ano yung bullish sa'yo? Kailangan ba mag-break yung 9.9? Kailangan mag-break yung 11? Diba? Saan ka mag-a-add? Kung mag-a-add ka man. Saan ka magbabawas? Kung magbabawas ka man. Saan ka mag-take profit? Kung mag-take profit ka man. Diba? Hindi mo pwede sa akin sabihin na, kasi mag-trend follow lang ako dito. Eh kung nag-trend follow ka, ang fina-follow natin na trend right now, unfortunately, is pababa pa. Okay, again, hindi po tayo nang babash. Neutral analysis lang. Okay? Sa akin lang po, paalala lang na kung may hawak kayo or nag-iisip kayo pumasok, make sure that you know what you're looking for, you know what you want to see, you know where you want to see it, okay? And you know what you're gonna do if and when you do see what you want to see. Okay? With that said, that's it, no? Very simple lang yung multi-time frame analysis natin sa IMI kasi very obvious naman yung direction when we look at the higher time frames. We didn't even have to look at yung 3-month pataas. Diba? In fact, actually, let's take a quick look, no? Kahit sa 3-month, ayun nga, we tried to push higher. So, parang ganun din. So, if you were forming, kung ito yung low, nagganyan ka, low, higher high, from here, diba? Push down, low, potential higher low, here, then push down. So, kapag dito, pag sa very, very high time frame, pwede mo sabihin, kapag nag-break ng 3.2, pero sana naman, kung may hawak ka man ngayon, huwag mo nang hintayin yun. Flow lang ang tinitingnan natin. Pero, mention ko lang, since nandito na tayo. Sa 3-month, we're essentially stuck within this candle. Eh. Kaya natin nasabi na nag-range tayo sa lower time frames, diba? Kasi we're stuck within this candle. In fact, this month's candle is stuck within June's candle din. Diba? So, this quarter's candle is stuck within the previous quarter's candle din. So, we can say then from here na okay, kapag nasira yung range, diba? Kapag nasira, sabihin natin kahit ito, kapag nasira yung range na yan sa baba, then we can be more kumbagay assured na talagang nagmumukhang bearish na because the range that was formed using a higher time frame broke to the downside. Diba? So, interestingly, yes, hindi natin siya na-mark out nun, no? So, 8.5 was close around that area. But yan. Okay? So, ito yung itsura niya sa daily. If you want to take a screenshot of it, a snapshot of it for your reference. Okay? And with that said, I hope na nakatulong sa inyo tong video na to and may natutunan kayo. And if so, I would really appreciate it if you give this video a like and consider subscribing to my channel. Okay? Do you agree or do you disagree sa mga sinabi ko? Feel free to let me know in the comment section below. And as always, good luck and happy trading!